All right, joining us right now is Captain Amrinder Singh. Captain, it's been a long innings as the Chief Minister. Captain Amrinder, if you can hear me, it's been a long innings as a Chief Minister. I'm sure you have had great love being showered by the leaders as well as the population of Punjab. I want to know one thing from you. Were you not ever told in the past by your political party of how unhappy the MLAs were with you? Were you not ever told? Because you say you're humiliated.
Told by who? Told by who?
By the leadership of the Congress party. Were you not ever told that there are leaders who are unhappy with you?
Well, of course they told me. Not once, they've told me many times. They're unhappy. I can't make everybody happy in the government, when you're in the government. Somebody wants something done, you can't do it, so he becomes unhappy. That's a different thing. But as far as the general population, ask the Punjabi, why are you asking any leaders? Ask the Punjab, the people of Punjab, are they happy or are they not happy with our government?
You think your leaders in your party ganged up against you, Captain?
Some of them, yes. Some people who were close to me did do this. But that's okay, I don't mind, that's part of the game. You win some, you lose some, let them come. They will realize themselves in due course.
Captain Amrinder, what do you think, and do you think the major part of your humiliation, since you used that word, has to do with the fact that the top leadership gave repeated audience to Navjot Singh Sidhu?
No, I don't care about that. Do you know if I wanted an audience for me to say I couldn't have met anyone? I went to Delhi from last March when the COVID came to this time to now. I've only been four times. Twice to see the Congress president and twice to see the central leadership, the Home Minister and the Prime Minister on national security matters. And that is my job to do. And otherwise I don't go. I'm not one of those who runs out to Delhi every second week to go and see somebody. Why should I see it? I've got a job to do and do my job.
No, the reason why I'm asking you this question is because Mr. Sidhu is going all guns blazing against you. I mean, it almost appeared as if, you are his opposition. So do you think that he was doing out of his own volition or...
I don't know about I'm his opposition, but he's certainly...
Yeah.
I don't know what he's doing it or he's not doing it. But I can tell you that the man I've said this before, he was in my cabinet and he was a total disaster as a minister. 7 months he never cleared his files, and I can't let a man who is the local self-government, which was the urban ministry, development ministry, to do something and just sit on files. And that is not the way. Therefore, I removed him from there. And obviously, he's been bitter since. So he can go with all 10 guns blasting, I don't care. If he's being made the face of the Congress chief ministership, leadership, I will certainly oppose him. And the party, let him do what he wants. That's up to Delhi to decide. But national government of Punjab means national security. I've got a 600-kilometer border with Pakistan. And I'm not going to allow a man like him to emerge here. And if he comes as the face of the Congress, I will oppose him.
No, Captain, you are saying you will oppose him as the face of the party. Don't you think he has already been made the face? So you're happy with any other person being made Chief Minister, but not Navjot Singh Sidhu?
No, I'm not saying state of the party. Listen to me. I'm not opposing him as he's a PCC president. He can do anything he wants in a PCC president. That's the Congress president's decision. But coming as the face of the party in the Congress, for the Chief Ministership, where his alliance is so close with people in Pakistan, with the Pakistan Army Chief and the Pakistan Prime Minister and all, that is a matter of national security. And therefore, I will oppose that.
But Captain Singh, how is it a matter of national security? For instance, just to play devil's advocate, if he speaks to the Prime Minister or knows someone...
You don't know what he's been doing?
No, I know about his advisors also. The very silly comments that they made.
He has... When he was going to Pakistan for Imran Khan's meeting, for his swearing in, I rang him up in Andhra Pradesh, he was there. I said, don't go. He didn't listen to me. He needs the Chief Minister's permission to go. Anyway, he went there. After that, there he hugged that general when our soldiers are being killed every day. Today I am getting umpteens of weapons and explosives and heroines and whatever else is coming through drones into Punjab. And that is the Pakistan Army doing it. Doing that and also killing our soldiers over there. The ISI and all is doing it. And anyone who is here has, as Chief Minister, has to look after national security as well. And this man is incapable of doing it. And therefore, I will oppose him.
Captain Singh, why? In an earlier interview, I heard you saying that there's something mentally wrong with Navjot Singh Sidhu. Why would you come to such a conclusion?
I never said mentally wrong. I never said mentally wrong. I don't use these words. But I said that he was incapable of running. Look, why can't a man who's the minister of local self-government clear a file? What was his problem? Is it more important to go down to Bombay and sit in a chair and laugh in some program than clearing files for the Punjab government? I don't have confidence in the man. I think it's a big disaster if they're going to make him the face of the Congress for the election.
Captain Singh, do you feel that right now you have concentrated a bulk of your anger against Mr. Navjot Singh Sidhu, whereas there was a high command that gave him that audience, gave him that space? So do you feel that somewhere the blame lies with the high command as well?
I have told them quite clearly that the man is not capable, not competent. I've given all the things. Despite that, they want to make him, let them make him. That's his. But when it comes to national security, then it's my job also. I have to live in the state. I may not be chief minister, but it is my state. And I've been through the most horrendous of times before the Blue Star and after Blue Star. And I don't want Punjab ever to come that way again. And this man's incompetence will take us that way.
Two quick questions before I let you go. You've had a long day. Are you still a congressman and will you remain one? Because sources in the Congress party are telling us that in 2017 also, some people accuse you of trying to do business with the BJP.
This many times. What business can I do? Any chief minister who comes to has to talk to the BJP when it comes to national security. All your agencies are central agencies. I have to bring back big fish from the drugs. That comes through Interpol. Interpol comes through the Ministry, Government of India. I mean, there are issues that you have to deal with. I've got drones coming down. I have no capacity to shoot down those drones. So I have to meet the Home Minister to say, find some capacity to shoot down the drones. Because weapons are coming, narcotics are coming, all these sort of things are coming. Any government, any chief minister who comes will have to deal with the government of India as far as national security is concerned.
Captain Singh, my final...
Let me tell you, you're talking only of the... one minute, just listen to me.
Sure.
You're only talking about the Prime Minister and the other minister. What about the other ministers we have to deal with? I just have to deal with the food minister. Our paddy crop is about to come in. We've got to deal with the finance minister. We've got to deal with the industry minister. We've got to deal with the external affairs minister. I've got people stuck in other parts of the country. I'm writing letters every day and telephoning people to get them released. Who else is going to do it? Do I have the capacity as a state to do it?
Okay, Captain Singh, my final question to you. What next? This is going to be a question that will be asked of you, I'm sure has been asked of you. Many leaders who stood in support with you attended the CLP meeting also. It's very clear that you may have resigned, but you have not retired. Captain Singh, what does this mean? Do you remain in the Congress? Do you have your own outfit? What's your political course from here on?
I don't know. I sense so outside Adhbhavan, which you're probably referring to, that politics is... a very fluid game. One doesn't know where it is and what it is. Let us see. It's a flexible game, and one has to think. You have to talk to your friends, you've got to talk to your colleagues, and then you have to make up your mind what you want to do.
Will you remain a congressman, Captain Singh? My final question.
When we are ready with an... I can't give you any answer. I can't give you an answer. I will at some time. I will once I talk to all my colleagues. Don't think I'm the only one who's upset with this current setup. There are many people.
But there's more politics left to you, Captain.
Set up in Punjab, I mean. No?
I'm saying there is much more politics left to do for you.
I think so. I'm not putting up I'm giving things up. Not at all. I'm going to fight it out. When I retire, it will be after winning a battle, not losing a battle.
So there's a battle to be won, Captain Singh.
And you'll do it. There is.
Always nice talking to you, Captain Amrinder Singh. Thank you so much.